Independently if you're developing pipelines or writing software, unit tests, it's always one of the main software development practices that everybody agrees that it's a good idea to have. So let's go into authoring into a pipeline and let me show you how you can write a unit test within your pipeline to test the code that you write inside Foundry. We start with the Foundry reference project. Let's open a data source and add a unit test to it. We can go with the flight control system. Once we open it, we can see there's a repository inside. Opening the repository exposes both Python and SQL transforms. We're interested in the Python transforms, so let's open it. And we can see that there is a collection of pipeline code here, but there aren't any tests. We can also observe that master is locked. So let's create a branch so that you can push some code in. Let's call our branch add unit tests. We hit create. And once the branch is created, we can now start doing some setup. We can start by going to build Gradle and see if the plugin that runs PyTest is active. In this repo, it was already active. Sometimes it's commented out, so you should come here and uncomment it. We should also create a package called test in the source folder so that we can have a place that hosts our test that PyTest will recognize. Within it, let's create a new file using PyTest nomenclature, which is test underscore some name. Here we're going to call it example, but please give it a name that's normally meaningful to you. We create it, and because it's a Python file, it comes with a template transform. We don't need it, so let's delete it, and let's create a test using PyTest nomenclature as well, where we'll be asserting true against false. Now, this assertion is going to fail for sure, but let me show you the test failing. After all, assert test equals false, it's always going to fail. And here we see the CI running. And once the CI finished, we can see that the test failed. Opening the details shows us that it was expecting true, but it actually got false, which is the correct result on this test. You can also hit play if you want to run the tests here, which doesn't require you to wait for the CI checks, and it's often faster. However, this test is not very meaningful. After all, we're just comparing true and false. Let's actually add some a pipeline test, something that touches PySpark. Let's go into the flights pipeline code and let's select a random line. For example, line 34 here has a bit of PySpark code that we can use for to write a test around. So let's copy it. And let's create a new function where we can call it mark null tail numbers, which returns the resulting data frame from that expression. So here it is. It receives a data frame. It does a fill nulls with an A and returns data frame. Afterwards, we can import the function from flights, where you can just say from my project datasets enriched.flights imported. And pause the video here if you want to read the code. We pass the Spark session and we assert if the tail number is a string. I'd like to note that we're using the keyword is, which in Python actually compares references, doesn't compare the content of the string. And because of that, it's actually making the test fail. So because a developer may often miss a detail like this, you actually have a green line, which we can see here. Once mousing over, it gives you a warning. Please use equals to compare string literals, or bytes, or tuples, etc. And the warnings on the bottom also warn you about it. Using string equals actually compares the content of the strings, not the references, which will make this test pass. You should always pay attention to the linter. Well, let's also remove the test that was meaningless and commit. And now we should have the test passing. Here we go. We now have the test passing. If you go back to the code, you'll see that we were passing a fixture called Spark Context. It gives us the access to the Spark Context created data frame. And here we can now finish this with a pull request where we say add pipeline test. Create, let someone review it and merge it. And that's it. Thank you for listening.